So as we talk about motivating Christians to be involved in the public square, I think it's very important, and we can see some of the polling data with respect for, to the next generation, the younger generation, and some of the different philosophies that they are embracing. There's a huge debate, and I think we want to touch on it here in our conversation today, about the whole nature of socialism. And I'm sure that there are some things that you would have to say about what a socialistic form of government looks like versus the democratic or the constitutional type of government that we have here in America. It seems to me that they are somewhat like oil and water.
Well, if you're a Christian and you believe the Bible and you're a socialist, then you're schizophrenic. Because socialism is based upon the belief that men are created basically good or at least neutral, and that they will work according to their ability and just receive according to their need. That's not the way human beings are. And every socialist government in history has failed. It is only capitalism that produces wealth. All socialism does is argue over how you're going to divide a never-increasing pie. Capitalism bakes pies.
Bakes pies, yes.
And then you can have a discussion about how the wealth gets distributed. I think Winston Churchill said it best, as he often did. He said the weakness of the capitalist system is that it inequitably distributes the fruits of its system. The weakness of the socialist system is that it equally distributes the miseries of its system. And that's exactly right. I mean, England went from the richest country to the poorest country in Western Europe when it had a 30-year experiment with socialism. Socialism has never worked anywhere in the world at producing wealth. All it does is produce misery, and it produces, increasingly, it produces a dictatorial government. We believe men are basically not good. They're sinful. That's why they're not going to work unless they get to keep a lot of what they make. But also, that's why we have the system of checks and balances we have, because our forefathers understood that government would try to aggregate power to itself. And so we have three different branches of government competing for power and competing with each other and watching each other. And it's sort of divide and conquer to keep us from having despotism.
So as we look at socialism, and we also hear a number of terms such as cultural Marxism and these different philosophies that are of the same ilk, and the younger generation seems to be gravitating toward those. Why do you think that is?
They've been brainwashed. Yeah. They've been brainwashed. If you've sent your children to public schools, if you've sent your children to public colleges or private colleges, unless it's a very special Christian college, they've been brainwashed. That's what they've been taught by people who have been giving out propaganda to them as fact, and they don't know their history. And if you don't know history, you're bound to repeat it. As Mark Twain said, history doesn't repeat itself, but it often rhymes. They don't know about our system of government. They don't know about world history. They don't know about the failures of communism and the excesses of communism in Russia and China and Venezuela and Cuba and Nicaragua. They don't know about it. They don't know how it's failed every time it's been tried. So I would say that our young people, we've failed our young people by allowing them to be propagandized in the public schools and in colleges. And we need to rectify that, and we need to do the best we can to help them to understand that what they've been taught is wrong.